which the title is taking things into his own hands. And I'm going to focus my presentation on some of the lessons that I learned from this chapter, especially in terms of transparency and the rule of law, which I will expand further on my presentation. So Dr. Golfo, up to this point, he claimed in this book that he has done everything that the FDA has asked him in order for his product, his machine, go through approval. But evidently, that hasn't happened. On two chapters six, I think it has passed at least 2 years since they first submitted the PMA, and they're stuck. There's nothing happening, and it seems it's going the approval going in the wrong direction. So he decided to take the matters into his own hands. It's the title of the chapter. And basically, what I'm going to point out is some of the things that Dr. Golfo point out as what are the issues that he has with the FDA. Because at this point, he's going desperate, and he was even considering taking the agency into federal court. So, one of the main issues, the FDA doesn't keep up with innovation. And I put nanotech here in my slide. Of course, we deal with a lot of inventors, of course, Dr. Ferrari, and he mentioned nanotech as one of the examples of why, of a technology that can further foster innovation in the medical field, do a lot of help in patients, and the FDA, according to him, doesn't have a clue of what is nanotech. So the lack of expertise in the FDA reviewers is an impediment for innovation to grow in the market. Also, one of his main issues with the approval process is, and you guys have talked about this before, and mentioned this is the shifting of the goalposts. So first, the FDA tell them some guidelines, they follow it, and at the end, based on Dr. Golfo, they added some other stuff that they have to make in order to comply with the requirements. And to me, his main issue that he has is that the FDA didn't abide to the binding protocol that the agency and his company signed a couple of years before to that point. And I mean, it's very discouraging that you get a commitment from an agency, a government agency, which you expect transparency and that they will follow the rule of law, then to not honor a document, legal document that they signed in order to expedite this approval process in a timely manner. And of course, another issue he said is the negative image that the company had in the media and in the medical community. That is, in terms of Dr. Golfo's viewpoint, it was a damage that it was never overcome. What are the consequences of these actions or the way FDA was handling their approval process? Of course, investors were going away from the company, and even harder to bring new ones to the board. And of course, they were trying to do an extra $9 million financing sequence to proceed. It was very hard to accomplish it. Of course, the value of the company went down in the market, and for